Hi guys, Russ here from Wilson Land and Cattle Company. Have you had pink eye outbreak in your herd? Pink eye can be very detrimental to your cow herd, and we've experienced this in the past. And I've done two videos on it, and I didn't publish either one of them because it's so controversial how to take care of the problem and what causes the problem and all that. But you guys have been asking me about pink eye quite a bit, so I thought that I would address the problem. And if you don't like my solutions, just hit the skip button and don't watch the video. Pink eye outbreaks in your cow herd, it typically happens fall, summer. It can happen any time of the year. And whenever you do have an outbreak, you can get it in up to 80% of your cows. The disease is IBK, and it stands for infectious bovine keratoconjunctivitis. There's a lot of different ways of controlling it, and the reason a lot of people ask me questions, because we're always grazing, or a lot of the time we're grazing in tall stuff like this, and it's believed that it causes eye irritation and will cause pink eye. If you watch the beginning of the video, there's not one cow in our cow herd that has pink eye. And I've had a lot of reports, there's a lot of pink eye going on around this year. What do we do to prevent it? There's a lot of things that cause the pink eye, or usually comes from, is eye irritation, such as UV light, dust, getting little particles of seeds caught in our eyes, getting poked, thistles. There's a lot of things that can cause it. It's believed that flies cause it. Flies don't cause it, flies spread it. I don't know, you can see here in the herd, you see there's a little bit of a fly load on the cows. Here's the bull. You can see there on his side, he's got some flies. This cow here, she has flies. We typically don't do anything for flies in our cow herd. What we've had problems with in the past though, getting pink eye and treating pink eye, we always keep records, health records on our livestock. And in those health records, we find or have found specific genetic lines of cattle are more susceptible to the pink eye. And we've called complete genetic lines. We've had three genetic lines that we've called out of the cow herd. But we've treated cows. One of the best treatments for pink eye is oxytetracycline or Draxxin, and then patch the eye to help prevent or get the UV light off the eyeball, prevent the spread of the disease. But normally, once it's in the cow herd, it's going to spread no matter what you do. I mean, it is what it is. What do we do to prevent it? Well, like I said, we've called entire genetic lines of cattle. A vaccination with a booster, that didn't work. We would vaccinate and booster the cow herd and still end up with 10 or 15 cases out of 100 cows. And to be quite honest with you, dealing with pink eye is a real pain in the butt. I absolutely hate treating the cows for pink eye. It can cause weight loss in your calves. The calves can lose up to 10% of their weight gain. So you end up with dink calves. And it used to be if a cow got it in a cow herd, it would spread it to the calves and then we'd have a problem. But what we're doing to prevent the pink eye now is, being that we have it, and there's a lot of cattle in my area, so there's flies that can spread the disease, not from my farm, from somebody else's farm, we're vaccinating. I know a lot of people are considered all natural and whatnot, but you know, according to the organic certifications and the grass-fed certifications, vaccinations are allowed. And the reason for jab vaccinations are allowed is because they work. Pink eye is a very, very painful disease. You'll see the cow, she'll be walking along, she'll have her head high, and it will be bobbing. Every time she blinks that eye, her head bobs, and the reason it bobs is because she's in so much pain. And if it's not treated, that cow could possibly lose her eye. It can be difficult handling cattle that have been blinded in one eye, or blinded in one eye and partially blinded in another eye. You know, it is what it is. That we found this new vaccination. We used to vaccinate and booster, and we'd still end up with a lot of pink eye in the herd. We found a one-shot vaccination deal, and it works extremely well. We haven't had any pink eye in the herd in a few years now, and I don't expect to have any pinkeye in the herd anytime soon.
Some other things that can impact the severity of pinkeye in your cow herd is, and it's not normally thought of, but what's the stress level in your cow herd? Are they really stressed? Are they not stressed? You know, they have heavy fly load, not fly load. Like here, our cows are in fairly poor quality forages, so they could be deficient in protein and energy, which could also cause a pinkeye outbreak. Are we giving a complete mineral ration to them? One of the vitamins that the cows really need is vitamin A, selenium, and iodine, which helps prevent or keeps their immune system up to where they're not susceptible to pinkeye and other skin diseases. Iodine is one of the, I talked to my nutritional doctors, and they really was pushing, make sure you get the iodine in that livestock, because that really helps the skin and the eyes. Hopefully this helped you out. Like I said, I made two videos prior to, and I just deleted them because I didn't want to get into the controversy on pinkeye, but it's something that I felt that we needed to make a video on and talk a little bit about, because you know, we're going on, I believe it's been almost 4 years now with not one case of pinkeye, and you know, we're at risk of pinkeye. I know that, and we don't get it, and I believe it's because we called the cows that the genetic lines out of the herd that was susceptible to it. You know, this is not thought of as a high quality forage. Let's go look and see where we're at. The cows are getting the best and leaving the rest for the soil biology. The soil biology doesn't need the high quality nutrients that the cows do. So we're just leaving those poor quality nutrients behind for the cows, or for the soil to digest it back in and regrow. We just moved out of this paddock here. You can see that gamma grass is still 24 inches tall probably. That's the poor quality forage. And you can see that there's a lot tramped down. You know, there's asters in here, there's tick trefoil, we got cup plant. You know, the stems of the cup plant are right there. We left that, so we're balancing the ration out to where their feed quality is a little bit better and their energy's better. One of the ways that we can tell our cows have the proper energy levels, let's see if I can get to where you can see here. See this cow up here, look at her ribs. It looks like somebody raked their fingers backwards on the ribs. Those are fat deposits underneath the hide, which tells me that they're receiving enough energy. And the calves, they're all fluffy, but they have, I've seen calves that have happy lines as well. It's hard to see here in the shade. All these girls have what they call happy lines. Let's go find the bull. His happy lines are more pronounced than most other animals. I don't know where he's at. It's kind of nice whenever you have a bull, it just blends into the herd and you don't even notice them. I really like that. Okay, right here, this cow up here, you can see she's a two-year-old heifer and she's got real nice happy lines. The protein needs, just by looking at their manure, they just moved in here so I can't find any manure. So we'll go back to the other paddock that we just come out of and look at the manure. Another way you can tell is to check the pH in their urine. Whenever they're receiving the proper protein, their urine will be perfect pH of 7. Go through here, see if we can find a cow pat. See here? It might be a little bit stiff, but it's still looking really well. See here, you want it to be the consistency of pumpkin pie with a dimple in the center of it when it drops out of the cow, but they've traveled through here quite a bit, so they got it spread around. That's how we tell if we have the proper energy and the proper protein levels in our livestock. we don't necessarily need to look at our forages. And don't forget to keep the minerals. I know we used to feed a lot of minerals here on the farm, and we're slowly working them out to where we're not feeding as much, but I don't think that there's ever going to be a time where we can't go without minerals completely. The main reason for that was our minerals is we used to have a lot of white mussels disease in the herd, and I believe with the deficiencies and stuff that we had in the minerals actually suppressed their immune system and let us be susceptible to pink eye as well. Hey guys, hopefully you found this video useful. IBK, also known as pink eye, infectious bovine carrato conjunctivitis. That's the big name for it. Really don't mean nothing to me. Just call it pink eye. It's a lot easier to say. Please subscribe, like, comment, share with a friend, and we'll see you on the next one. Talk to you later.